for the first time in 29 years, the annual York County Day, where state legislators from our area usually go together to Columbia to talk about our community. Well, this year, it's taking place right here at home.
CN2's Renee O'Neill joining us from the BMX track as the South Carolina lawmakers see sports tourism in action during the BMX World Championships.
Yeah, it's really an exciting day here as state legislators made their way to Rock Hill to talk with local business owners and York County representatives about what is important to York County. Now, city leaders tell me that this really lets the county shine to have people here for the BMX World Championships.
The best way to show off York County is in York County.
State legislators, local council members, and more gathering at the Novant Health BMX Supercross track.
Typically, we're touting York County down in the state capitol. This time, they're on our home turf.
It's representatives from York County, both of the chambers and businesses, go up and speak to the legislators about what's important to York County, where we see the county growing, what needs the county has, working with Pennies for Progress.
Speaker of the House of Representatives, Jay Lucas, who made the trip, says seeing York County firsthand shows what working together really means.
I think what's been going on in York County shows what can be done when state government works with local government. You can create areas like this.
Representative Gary Simrell has been a part of York County Day since the 90s. He says this event helps put our community on the map.
It shows what happens when you work toward a goal of making sure that Rock Hill and York County is a destination tourism attraction.
For Senator Wes Clymer, this is his first York County Day. He explains why it's important to let state leaders know what's going on in such a growing community.
I mean, they see the rapid residential growth, they see our commercial growth, they see our infrastructure needs, and so now, you know, working with other members of the York County delegation, when we're down at the Capitol talking about explosive growth or sports tourism or our infrastructure needs, now, a lot of these guys have seen it firsthand.
Chamber leaders say not only do they want to showcase Rock Hill, but of course the entire county. That's why each state legislator that came today got to go home with a basket full of items from local businesses within all of the county. For now, we're in Rock Hill. Renee O'Neill, CN2 News.
All right, Renee, a lot to show off for sure. York County Regional Chamber leaders say more than a dozen state legislators from around South Carolina did make the trip to Rock Hill.
Well, since the last time the BMX championships were held in the United States, that's back in 2001, and Louisville, Kentucky, Rock Hill really wanted to make this an epic return.
For the month of July, the city of Rock Hill is relaxing its sign ordinance and waiving all permits and fees. Businesses will be able to place temporary signs promoting the BMX World Championships. Sisters Fine American Cuisine, located there on Oakland Avenue in Rock Hill, says it was the first restaurant to take advantage of the new rules for signs the month of July by posting this one out front of the restaurant welcoming visitors. Owner and chef Chuck Hurst says he's already had customers come in who've seen information about his sister's restaurant there on the Comporium BMX app.
People in Rock Hill to be able to come in here and not be hustled and bustled and sit down and talk to people and stuff. We're a family-run business and a family-run restaurant, but we welcome anybody.
Chuck says he's in the process of adding new menu items and is excited to welcome visitors from all over the world. If you'd like to learn more about Sisters Menu and Hours, you can visit the website there on your screen.
Well, if you plan to go out to see the BMX races this week, there are some things you need to be aware of. Let's start with those ticket prices. They're located right there on your screen. Kids under 5 are free. You can buy those tickets online or at the track. Parking costs $10 at the track, but there is free parking in nearby lots with free shuttle service. And this Saturday, July the 29th, the last day of racing, Rock Hill wants you to help pack the track, they say. York County residents and their guests will get in free with a valid ID. There will be an award ceremony followed by fireworks.